Steph Curry, man, he is doing things that we have never seen been done in the NBA. And if you're a fan of Steph Curry like I am, or hell, if you're just a normal NBA fan, you know what Steph is capable of. I mean, we saw his MVP season in 2016, even though they did not win the championship that year. I can't lie, as far as peak years go, that is definitely among the best of them. But what he's doing right now is arguably just as impressive, because the roster he has around him isn't even close to the roster that he had in those 2015-2016 years with the Golden State Warriors, and obviously even the years with Kevin Durant. Because man, when I tell you the spacing on this team is garbage, I'm not joking. Like, I genuinely believe that teams wouldn't even defend anybody if Steph Curry wasn't on the court. That's just how valuable Steph Curry is to this team's offense, and why they even have a chance at winning any of these games. Obviously, there are some other players that contribute. Draymond Green contributes as a playmaker and defender. Andrew Wiggins has gotten better on defense this year, and offensively, he's been solid and consistent for the most part. Kelly Oubre, man, I can't cap. Kelly Oubre's stock, it plummeted this year badly, like really, really bad. He's gonna have to have a really good next season because it doesn't look good. And then to make matters worse, it looks like James Wiseman may have been a bad pick. Obviously, it is his rookie year, so you don't want to rush to conclusions. But looking at what LaMelo Ball, and I would even go as far as to say Tyrese Haliburton, have turned into, despite what Wiseman could potentially end up being, yeah, those guys look like they might be better players in the future. But regardless, Wiseman does have time to grow, and these years are just growing stages for him. In the coming years, we will really know how good he is in the future. He's here for the long run. He's not here for the now. But as of now, this team sucks. Like, straight up, they would be a 5-win team if Steph Curry did not exist. That's just how bad they are. And to further prove that, when Steph Curry is on the court, they have the 13th best offense in the league. But when he is off the court, they have the 7th worst offense in NBA history. When we talk about a floor raiser, that is what Steph Curry has been this season. Even just by the 8 games without Steph, they're 1-7. And one of those losses is a near 60-point blowout to the Toronto Raptors. I'm not even joking. They lost by 53 points. An embarrassment of a team right now. An embarrassment. And you know, it's crazy because I consistently heard that Steph Curry was going to struggle because he's not that guy. He can't carry a team. And I've consistently said, carrying a team is not as valuable as a lot of people say. Because let's not act like there are not players that can carry a team, but then you throw them on a team with talent and they're just nothing. Like Russell Westbrook or Kemba Walker. Those are two perfect examples of guys being able to carry a roster, but whenever talent was given around them, they struggled to succeed. Now, I do believe it's cool to see guys put teams on their back and put up nice numbers. It's nice to see that. But bro, you're not winning. And it sucks to see a player do all of this just to get the 8th seed. Or even if you want to raise the standards of a guy like LeBron James going to the finals, all to lose to the Warriors. What's the fun in seeing all of that? Yes, we were able to see some great moments that we will remember. But how about that moment in the finals where he dropped 51 and lost? Think about that. You think players like to go through all of this? Steph Curry just dropped 47 points against the Boston Celtics and lost. These are not years that we should want for Steph Curry's career, especially when we know he has plenty of years left in the tank. But regardless, I hope that he's proved to all of those haters out there that he is more than capable of carrying a team. Because the thing that's so crazy about this season that puts it atop of one of the greatest years I've ever seen, or should I say carry jobs I've ever seen, is that he's still just as efficient as he was even in his MVP season. Because along with averaging 31 points a game, he's also grabbing nearly 6 rebounds, facilitating 6 assists, while shooting 49% from the field and 43% from 3, while attempting a career high in 3-point attempts of 12 a game. And when you throw in that he's shooting 92% at the free throw line, that is just the icing on the cake of efficiency, because that brings his true shooting percentage to 66%. We are seeing one of the most efficient scoring years in history. And he's doing that while carrying a guy like James Wiseman, who can't do a post up to save his life. Or Kelly Oubre, who gets left open and still goes 2 of 8 every other game. Or Draymond Green, who teams just ignore on defense. And to be fair, he doesn't even look to score unless he has a wide open lane to the basket. And even him making those shots are not a guarantee. But before I conclude this video, let me leave you guys with this. Steph Curry right now is having a phenomenal season, and we all know. Now, is he in the MVP conversation like a lot of other people have said? No, I do not believe he is in the MVP conversation, just for the simple fact that the Warriors are not winning enough games. Because if you were to make him the actual MVP of the season, that would open up so many doors of players in the past that should have won MVPs. Guys like Anthony Davis could pop into mind, or Kobe Bryant pop into mind. Guys that may not have had the success in the regular season in the win column, but they definitely had the numbers and had to carry a load offensively. So for that simple fact of precedent and how things have been in the past, Steph Curry should not be an MVP candidate. Maybe he could finish top 5, but he shouldn't be among the legit guys who have consideration. But nonetheless, that does not take away what he is doing this season. Because when you've had 5 games in which you've had 10 three-pointers made or more in this season alone, that should more than prove that you are worthy of the title of being the greatest shooter of all time. And that's just the facts. But that concludes this video, and before I wrap it up, I would like to give information on the giveaway, because I did make a mistake in my last video by saying April 31st. I didn't even catch that until I watched the video, but by April 30th, I meant I will be announcing 2 winners for $100 gift cards each. And to be entered into that giveaway, all you have to do is go on the Nothing But Action Instagram page and follow us. And among all the followers, I will make a drawing, and whoever wins will be the winner of those gift cards. But without further ado, make sure you like this video, subscribe to the channel, push the bell for post notifications, and also comment your opinions down below. I would love to know what you guys think about Steph Curry's season this year, and just overall his career, and what do you think he's going to be able to do in the future with the Golden State Warriors as they enter a new era. Make sure y'all follow me on social media, my Twitter, Instagram, all those handles are in the description box down below. But y'all stay safe, have a blessed day. This is your boy Young Mustard signing out. Peace.